Here, giving feedback here. Okay, and then you wait a few more minutes. You know, they're kind of all doing the same thing. Like, I'm giving feedback there, but they're not fixing what I'm giving them. So you blow the whistle, tweet. Hey, everyone. Everyone needs to bend their knees more. Needs to move your feet. Everyone understand? All right, let's go again. Okay, now three out of the four are kind of getting it. Okay, and you're recognizing, oh, so-and-so, maybe he's having more trouble now. So you say, hey, tweet. You guys, three, continue. And then you have one-on-one fixing, showing them, taking the stick, going, look, see? Because there is different ways people learn. Okay, so what are the ways people learn? What would you think? If you have to guess. There's three things. So visual. They have to be diagrammed and drawn out, which is why it's so important to demonstrate what you want. Right? It'd be easy to say, you guys are going to create a square over there, and you're going to pass to this person, and you're going to pass to that person. Okay, everyone understand? And everyone's like, shh. What? Yeah. And they go and run away and go, what? Okay? It's important to visually show them the drill setup and walk through it once. So they get an understanding for the visual learners. Okay, what's the other one?
Auditory.
So what is auditory? Listening. So, you know, they don't necessarily need to see, they just need to hear. What are the key points? You know, hands apart, bent knees, stick to the right. That's all they might hear to learn. Okay, what's the third one?
Kinesthetic.
Yeah, kinesthetic. So the feeling of it. So remember at the start there, right? She had her hands like this. I said, put it here, and then she went back here. So then I have to actually show her, right, by feeling, just demonstrate here, right, by taking the stick and turning it, right, and getting them to feel what that feels like. Okay? So they might learn by the feeling of it, the kinesthetic. And some learners might learn all three. They might be a little bit more visual, but they still are, you know, auditory and need to hear, and they need to feel, need to learn by doing it. Okay? You guys understand that? Okay. Great job. Great. Last thing, how would you progress the drill? How would you add to this drill? So you think of it, what would you change now? They got it on this way.
Go this way. Maybe go cross by this way.
Right, absolutely.
Crosswise.
Yeah,
that's
counterclockwise. Okay, so that's a change in the drill. How would you progress it? How would you add a really big progression? Like there, now you're into practice five, and they're really good at going this way and that way and across. How would you progress? Close, but you're not into the game yet. How would you just progress this drill? Would you know? Yeah, maybe we're staying on the reverse. Reverse perception now. Going the same way. What else? The odd defenders?
Yes.
Yeah, you might have a monkey in the middle now. Now I'm a defender. Right? And I'm chasing. Right? And trying to prevent them from passing. So now they can pass clockwise, counterclockwise, across, but now you have a defender. You guys see that? So great drill, just a basic drill, passing, receiving, but where you can go, how you can give the feedback. Okay, good. Okay, next group up. Let's go with your group. Okay, you're gonna teach the group that was just teaching. Okay. Okay, and the others that were demonstrating, the participants, you're gonna come over here. Okay, so you guys are the teachers. These are the four.
We're doing the Indian dribble, so how are we going to start this? Okay, bust. Do you want to...
Lower the base, stick to stand, right?
Hang on, sorry, I'm just gonna stop again. I want you to come over here. You to come over here. Come in here, stand in front of her. Oh, down close. Okay, the very first thing that you have to do before you get into what the skill is you need to set them up. Where do they need to be? Do they need to be in two lines, three lines? Do they need to be in a square? You need to tell them, where do you want them to stand? That's why I call them together.
Half circle.
Okay,
half.
So how do you want them to snap? Because you're going to run the square.
And circle?
Half circle.
Okay.
Half circle.
Good.
That's good. So now, today we're going to be learning about Indian dribbling. So first, you need to grab on your stick and your leg position. Left hand on the top and right hand in the middle. And right hand you need to do this not too tight, that you will be too tight. You cannot hold your stick, move. And then your ball, they need not very close or not outside. This is your needle. And your middle of the feet. And then bend your leg. And then your stick, you need to reach your stick to the ball. And then you will drifting to side to side. And move and stop. And if you have the side will be tight, you cannot turn your stick. This is very hard exercise, Indian dribbling. So now we will be trying and practice and tomorrow we will be perfect.
So to start off, we want you guys to practice without a ball, right? So just practice the motion of bringing the stick over, right? Stay comfortable with that motion.
You can tell people this is not the normal situation where you have four coaches and four participants. keep that in mind. But he comes like, hey, stop, right? And you'll get kids bang, bang, bang on the field, and they won't be paying attention, so stop. He thought it was perfect, okay? And he sets you guys up on where he needs to go, okay, with the lines. But now he's here. Can you see back there? No. Can you? No. So instead of going, instead of setting them up on where they want me to be, it depends on the age group, what I might do, okay, is in, they were in a half circle before you tell them to go somewhere, right? They were already in a half circle. You, let's pretend that they were in this half circle in front of them. You would say, okay, you guys have done it stationary. Now I want you guys, we're going to use these two lines so everyone can see, and you're going to, you definitely want this and this and that, right? So everyone can see. Okay, but this is, I'm just adding to kind of that teaching on can everyone see, okay? The use of lines is perfect, okay? You will need to use those lines on the field, right? Visual, right? Especially if you want them to go a certain distance, right? Or you're dribble from that black line to this red line. You don't have to put a bunch of cones down. You're not wasting